folks, Bob Collins for Diver Supply. This is going to be the third video in the series of staff picked videos that we're doing. And this one is going to be on staff pick regulators. Now, one of the interesting things about it, we've had quite a bit of discussion here today about regulators and what it means to have staff picks and such. And of course, I have to put a little bit of a disclaimer out here because we don't have all of the regulators manufactured in the world here, but we have a predominance of what's popular out there. And of course, what Diver Supply carries. Now, a lot of the staff here have experience far beyond working in Diver Supply and such. Myself, I've been diving over 50 years, and of course some in the military and recreationally. But I got a lot of input from the other staff about what I'm putting out in front of you here. And just like we did in the other video, we're going to be breaking this regulator evaluation or regulator recommendation down into three tiers. We're going to talk about our upper level tier, where maybe somebody comes in and they say, I don't have a budget, show me something along those lines, the most expensive. Now, you understand that the best I can buy has a certain level of qualification to it, okay? Because sometimes the best that you can buy for $500 versus the best you can buy for $1,000 versus the best you can buy for $300, it's, again, is all relative. But we're going to break these down into those three tiers, the upper tier, the medium tier, and what we call the, we're going to just call it for better terms, the lower tier or the least expensive tier. And in essence, we're actually not going to include the very, very, very bottom tier of regulators, because most people who are not just occasional divers will spend a certain level of money on their regulators, because what's the most important thing when we're down there? And that, of course, is being able to breathe. And that's why people make a lot of personal choices as far as regulators go. In addition, we've also discussed this situation where people have been told, oh, my dad uses Scuba Pro, so I'm not going to buy anything but Scuba Pro. Or I only am going to dive Apex because that's what I see all the cave or cavern divers doing or purchasing, that sort of thing. So we're going to be a little bit more pragmatic about this as far as what do we see people purchasing, features within the different tiers of regulators. And of course, what we see and what our experiences are in choosing a regulator for our personal or professional use. Now to start, we're going to talk about the upper tier. What I've got in front of me here is I've got a couple of upper tier regulators, and understand there's a lot of us that really enjoy some of the different brands and some of the different features. And of course, some of us use these regulators for different purposes. Somebody that's cave diving, of course, is going to prefer maybe a den style first stage. Whereas like myself, I do strictly, you know, instruction, teaching. So I tend to use a yoke style first stage, but that neither here nor there. But in these upper levels, we've got a couple of units. This particular unit that I've got my hand on here, this is a Scuba Pro Mark 25, and it comes in this particular configuration with the S600. Now, this is an extremely popular piston-style regulator first stage, and it has a turret on it. And the reason it has a turret on it, and most people don't quite understand, is when you've got that reg in your mouth and you move your head, if the hose has got pressure on it and it's a stiff rubber hose, then having a turret actually helps you somewhat keep that regulator in your mouth, okay? So that's the Mark 25. Now, this is not an environmentally sealed first stage. The S600 second stage is a very lightweight composite style second stage. It has full adjustability with also the Venturi and the what we call the braking pressure. And basically what that means that the Venturi can make it less sensitive to free flow. And I think most of you know what free flow is. And of course you're able to adjust your braking pressure, and that means how hard you need to suck in. So that's the Scuba Pro Mark 25 with the S600. Now I'm going to show you a picture. I've got one on display. It's the Mark 25 Black Tech, and it has the G260 second stage on it. I'm going to put this up on the screen here in just a second. Now that's also, the configuration is slightly different. The second stage is a little bigger. It has full adjustability just like the S600, and it's extremely popular. And it's just kind of a specialty type, but again, just follow the fact that the Mark 25 with some of these nice Scuba Pro second stages are extremely popular. The next one is also going to be a Scuba Pro. Now this is one of their new units, and this is called the Mark 19. Now this actually was out a few years ago and they've brought it back. It is also a turreted first stage, but this is actually a diaphragm style first stage, and it is environmentally sealed. Now, the 420 second stage is very unusual in its design, and they've designed this to kind of match some of their other design outlines and such that they've got going on. And it is adjustable here on the top, and it doesn't necessarily have a side adjustability for Venturi. This one adjustment combines both of what you saw on the S600. So this is new and has become fairly popular and is in that upper price level. Now, we're going to look over here again, and what we're going to be looking at is the Aqualung Legend Elite. Now, the Legend Elite is a very interesting first stage. Again, I'm going to put this up on the screen so you can see it. It's a very interesting first stage. It has angle cuts on it so that it routes your hoses in a specific manner that makes it very, very comfortable. And it is a diaphragm style first stage, and it also is what they call a dry chamber on the first stage that makes theirs a environmentally sealed first stage unit. And it's got a very unique look, and it's a beautiful unit. Now, it also has what Aqualung calls an ACD, an active closure device, so that when you attach it to the valve and you tighten it down, it actually opens up and allows air out of the valve into the first stage. When you unscrew it, it closes that little valve, no problem. So the second stage on this is also, it's just a gorgeous piece, as you're going to see from the pictures. And it has full adjustability, somewhat like the S600 here. And it's this particular regulator is probably one of the favorites of all the staff here. So I did a video on this before, and I put a link up here on that particular video. I actually said this in the other video. It's a piece of jewelry. It's beautiful. Now, what we're going to look at is we're going to look at our middle tier. And in our middle tier, we've got a couple of regulators here. And the first one I'm going to point out is this is the Mares, or Mares, depending on your vocabulary, where you're from and whatever. But I tend to call it Mares. And this is the Mares Epic. Now, this is a fairly new regulator out there. It has a turreted first stage, and the turreted first stages are pretty popular. And it has a braided hose instead of a hard rubber hose. It has a really good looking second stage that is adjustable using the one knob. And one of the things that you're going to notice about this first stage, I'm going to jump back to the first stage. When we look at this, if you mount this unit with the turret up, then what you're going to see is the high pressure hose here is automatically pointed down. Now, if you mount this in the other direction with the turret down, then the high pressure hose comes off from the other side and it's actually going to be pointed down also. So it just depends, instead of these being pointing straight out, then it has a certain level of design compensation for how you mount it and how you wear it on your first stage. So why would you mount it one way or another? Well, if you're swimming along and you tend to look up, and when you look up, you bump the back of your head on the first stage, you're probably going to want to lower your tank down in your BC. And what you're able to do is, if you look at this, you'll see the distance between whether the turret is closer to your head or if you turn it over, the bottom is closer to your head. And of course, there's also, this is a balanced first stage, but one of the things about it is this is not an environmentally sealed first stage per se. Now, this particular regulator doesn't use ACD, it uses AST, which is a closure device based on the actual pressure being turned on. So nothing goes into the first stage that would cause contamination. So it's just a different set of letters, but it does the same thing. Now, our other regulator in the middle tier is going to be Apex. Now, a lot of times people don't know Apex, but Apex is actually an Aqualung brand, and this particular unit is called the Apex XTX50. And I'm going to start here on the second stage and show you again. It has full adjustability. It's a nice size composite case on the second stage. And when we look at the first stage just happens to be a DIN connection on this first stage. This is also a turreted first stage. So I think what you're doing is starting to pick up maybe a theme on the fact that a lot of people like the turreted first stages. And this is an environmentally sealed first stage and is extremely popular with the folks that are tech divers, side mount divers. So that's the middle level of regulators. Let's look at the lower level or entry level. Now, the regulator I've got in my hand here, this is one that we're putting in the lower tier. And the reason we're putting it in the lower tier is more because of price point than we are worrying about per se quality. This particular regulator was compared to some of the more expensive regulators by Scuba Lab a few years ago, and actually was editor's choice. And if folks, you got to understand too that if you put a blindfold on and you had the same mouthpiece on some of these different regulators, you probably couldn't tell the difference in the breathability in many of them. But this is the Hog, it's called the D3, and it comes with a braided hose, and this is called the Xena second stage. This first stage, again, has a turret, and it is a diaphragm first stage. It is a balanced first stage, and it is environmentally sealed. The second stage is very, very attractive. It has full adjustability on the braking pressure and on the Venturi. And it's got a small purge button on the front, a little bit stiff, and there's a purpose for that, because if you swim into a current with some of the regs that have a very soft cover on them, they can actually free flow a little bit because you're swimming into a stronger current. So that is the Hog unit. Now, there are, like I said, a number of other regulators out there. So again, this particular video is subjective to all of that. So we appreciate you guys watching. If you're new here, please reach down and hit the subscribe button. If you dive with one of these regs or one of the other regs, love hearing or seeing your comments. The computer video I did recently, we've had a lot of great comments about people that have bought some of computers. And we'd love to hear some comments from you out there that dive some of these and some of the other regulators that are your choice. So we enjoy your input. I'm Bob Collins for Diver Supply, and as we always say here, dive safe. Thanks for watching.